from Warsenal Studio B in Chandler, Arizona, this is MayaCast.
Welcome to another edition of MayaCast. I'm your host, Tom Shadle.
I'm your host, Kip Barcel.
And this is episode 332 for Friday, July 23rd, 2021. Hashtag 5 the Tohaa. Coming on today's show, we are going to run down each of our top five units in the Tohaa Army list, much like we did with O-12 about, 6 or 8 weeks ago, and we said, and next week we're going to do Tohaa. Well, now it's next week with some shows in between. So that is what we are doing, and so we sort of come up with a top 10 list, because we each have a top five, but I'm sure that we will have some overlap. We shall see. But without further ado, let's get into our list.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend.
If you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the result of 100 battles.
Then, have they resisted, sir?
Yes. But why are they using such primitive weapons?
Now entering the war room.
All right, so these are in no particular order, other than at least the order of mine are in the order that they were on the in the army, in Infinity Army, with my current settings. Right, so no particular order. This is not a 5-1 or anything. I'm just not ranked. These are just my five favorite units out of Tohaa, and I'm gonna start with Hatail Aelis Kisan.
Okay,
she is. So first of all, she has sensor, and your only other choice for sensor is a Chaxa.
That's a good point.
And Chaxa's good. It's cheap. It's Chaxa Auxilar. It's cheap. It's but it's by itself.
Yeah.
And usually I use the Chaxa just for area control because they have baggage, right? And so I'm going to move them into my close zone or zones if it's quadrant. Supremacy, right? And they're going to stay there being 30 points worth of models in a 10-point price tag while, and not really go out and get in range to do sensory things. But, that's a fine option. But she also has sensor. She's whip 14, so auto, right?
Yeah.
Plus six. And, she is your only option for that other than the checks that she had. I got to lose these glasses because I can't
see
see the iPad. So she can triad.
Yeah.
So she's huge. Moving up the field with Eclipse Smoke support and heavy weapon support, or maybe she is your weapon. She got a killer hacking device, which is crazy because Tohaa didn't have those before. And she was fine without it, but she's got a killer hacking device and, so she's a specialist, and she is either 29 points with a K1 combi rifle or 30 points with a viral combi rifle. And, I mean, both are great. The combi is, of course, double action and shock, and it goes against BTS.
And
then the K1 is, your target is armor 0, right? And it's just damage 13. So both good options. I like the viral. Because two saves is nasty always. She has a flash pulse, right? So whip 14 again. So for long range, viral combi, K1 combi, only 16 inches. Now flash pulse gives you another 8 inches of range to get a plus 3 band. She has decharges in her pouch. Remember how we were talking about the Muyibs?
Yeah.
When we talked about the Spec Ops last week.
Yeah.
And we're like, they just come with everything to start with. Well, her too, So if you draw a classified where you need decharges or you have the mission with the AC-2, she's got that as well. And she gave me to try it. She is just a toolbox of things. Triangulated fire. You know, if there's something real far away in cover with momentism minus six and, that you would have a real, real hard time hitting, well, she can spend an entire order, shoot at that thing, and just take a minus three with her plus one burst from the fire team. And that is...
it's a lot easier to do with the new dodge rolls now, too.
To
set that up.
Because your previous order, you move and then
dodge, he's only physique 12, mm-hmm. but 60% of the time it works every time. And then that dodge move doesn't provoke Aera, so she can get into a position where she can then spend the next entire order. Because you're right, it used to be real difficult to pull off because you have to do one order of, oh my God, I'm going to die, before you can spend that entire order. But she's got, so she's got all these different tools for all these different situations. And Ballistic Skill 12, which actually is, you know, decent in Tohaa, and has everything you need. She, she'd probably be in all of my lists.
And she used to be, even back in the day, and she's even better now. And because, the triangulated fire with the way dodge works, regeneration with the way that works, because that's also in the states phase.
Yeah,
so that doesn't provoke arrow. Yeah, it's just, it's really good. Man, all that, I was like, I should have put her on my list after you say that. I feel bad.
Okay, so downside, she has one wound, armor two. Okay, but again, she's going to be a triad with Eclipse Smoke.
Yeah, she's easy to stay alive.
And she has that regeneration at the end of every state's phase, so she's either dead or back up.
And she's a character, so in those classifieds where it's like characters count as...
Veteran.
Like veteran to do that, which is pretty cool, so... Yeah, so my first one, just because it's the first one on my list in no particular order, and you just said Eclipse Smoke, so let's go to McCall. Macaul, or is it McCall? Nobody knows.
I think if you say Macaul fast enough, it's just Macaul.
Yeah. these are, I mean, they had to make
Macaul.
Our lists.
It's on mine too.
Yeah, so I figured that's a good one to start with because then we can just go back and forth.
It is also one of my five.
Yeah, but
so down to a top nine list.
Yep. But it, for the fact that it can triad, and you come with Eclipse Grenades, which is it's so huge in Tohaa because not being able to nothing can see through it. It's really easy to get them around the field. It's what scares me the most when I'm facing Tohaa. I'm like always setting up for the Eclipse Smoke Charge of Doom. You know, and they're there to, that their job is to keep their triad safe. Heavy flamethrowers on two of them with contender Eclipse Grenades for 13 points. Contenders are good in arrow. Because you're burst two in arrow. There's also a boarding shotgun for 16 or a combi rifle option for 16.
Yeah, but.
I like the heavy flamethrower 13 ones the best.
Yeah, in all my Tohaa-ing, the only ballistic skill attack they've ever made was Eclipse Grenades. So, and if I wanted to be shooting at somebody else in the triad, I feel like the boarding shotgun, the combi rifle, those are... wasted points because that's not their role.
Exactly. Their role is keep your people safe.
Well, but they're also absolute monsters in close combat.
Yes.
With a stock of 23 plus martial arts level 2, so they're hitting on 26s. Martial arts level 2 also gives you a negative 3, but then they also have close combat attack minus 3 in the profile.
Right?
So they're so that's the old eye coal.
Yeah.
They're throwing a negative 6 back on your opponent while they're
so
getting
gross.
26 and adding 6 to their die. And then either a viral or double action close combat weapon, they're the same points. It's just, you know, do they have lower armor BTS? A lot of times things just don't have BTS, so viral is the way to go. Plus viral adds the shock component as well. But they're making two saving rolls anyway. Plus 6, you're critting on a 14 up.
Yeah, it's pretty scary.
And so now... unless you hit somebody with martial arts, and then it's a 17 or whatever. But, yeah, absolute monsters in close combat. And tying into that is their dodge plus 2 inches.
Yeah, which is, again, really good these days.
Yeah, somebody gets too close, and they successfully dodge. They're moving 4 inches again in base contact at the end of the order. So, and 13 points, man.
Yeah, it's a steal. Like, they have to be in everybody's top five. I mean... I've rarely played against Tohaa that didn't have McCall's on the table.
And that, I mean, it's clear why they made both of our top five lists.
Yeah, right?
again, if there's a drawback, it's one wound,
mm-hmm.
only armor one, but maybe you have a Kumotel bioengineer as your specialist in that triad that can just fix people up as you go while they're sitting in eclipse smoke.
Mm-hmm. And one thing I wanted to point out too is like, if their triad gets whittled down to one and it's just that Makul, then you get to use your impetuous orders after that mm-hmm. to be even more efficient. So they're just good all the way around. I prefer the viral close combat weapon. But if you're used to playing against opponents that are, you know, low armor but heavy BTS, like a Makul, it's armor one, BTS three. That double action's probably a little bit better for you right then. Yeah. So it's a trade-off. But I like the viral way more better.
So there's a lot of things in here that I didn't include on my five favorite units because mm-hmm. that's what it is. It's my five favorite units. It's mm-hmm. not the five most important units. So like Kael'tar yeah. specialists, for example,
mm-hmm.
they're the guys that bring you the symbiomates and symbiobombs, and especially the mates for mm-hmm. the armor 9, BTS 9 total immunity round of shooting that you get, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so they're, you know, they're a necessary component that you're likely always going to take, but they're not one of my five favorites just because yeah. they're an auto attack. Cavalry Sentinels being the only structure in your entire mm-hmm. list. And if you're playing highly classified or countermeasures mm-hmm. or something like that, where fix a structure might come up,
yeah,
you know, or you might draw that card, then, you know, a Cavalry Sentinel not only protects your backfield from impersonators, but also, you know, is that structure point that you can fix mm-hmm. with your engineer to get the classified. But, you know, again, not on my favorites,
mm-hmm.
you know, but they are necessary. So there's this long list of things I had initially that I had to slowly scratch out.
Yeah, to get whittle down yeah.
But my next, moving down the chart, and you started at the bottom, which is funny.
Oh.
is the Rasail boarding team.
Oh, nice.
And they got three wounds. There's, you know, they're transmutation, so they have a profile with two wounds that's armor 1, BTS 3, and then a profile with one wound that has armor 0, BTS 0. But, you know, so it's three wounds, though, that you have to do before they're unconscious. And they get cover all of the time because they have nanoscreen mm-hmm. in the active symbiome. Well, the active symbiomate, but the inactive symbiont armor, they lose the nanoscreen. It's part of their main armor. So once they're down to one wound, they lose the cover all the time. But they also come with a little buddy. And the Choxa peripheral, or peripherical.
I don't know what that is.
But the Choxa peripheral is a little Choxa buddy, little silhouette 2 heavy flamethrower dude who has mimetism. And so they're synced. They move and operate together. So, you know, you can come around a corner with this guy and offer bad choices.
Mm-hmm.
Do I shoot back at the Rasail because he's going to shoot me with, I don't know, boarding shotgun, combi rifle, light shotgun, viral combi, Spitfire? You know, am I going to eat a bunch of viral combi shots from the Rasail and shoot back to try and contest that? Or am I going to try and shoot the Choxa to get rid of the heavy flamethrower? That's probably not smart because if you get the controller down, then he goes away too. Or are you going to dodge to try and contest both?
Mm-hmm.
You know, or, you know, if you shoot back to contest the shots, then you're eating the heavy flamethrower, and that's not fun either. So he's got a little buddy. He's coming at you from two angles at once. He can force bad decisions.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times I see him being the lieutenant, because he's survivable with those three wounds. You can be really aggressive with him. Use his lieutenant order, right, mm-hmm. for that extra order. And he's a guy that actually wants to use it and get scrappy. And then once you've lost two wounds and you're down to inactive, then you can pull him back, hide him, keep him safe like a cheerleader lieutenant normally yeah. would. You know, and then have the Choxa just protect his boss.
Mm-hmm.
And no, it's just it's a great profile that's not too expensive. The viral combi rifle is 35. So 36 if he's your lieutenant.
Ooh.
But yeah, one more point to be your lieutenant. But I would take three extra orders on this guy for 1 point. Absolutely. They're super hard to put down if you've ever faced them. You know, you feel like you keep hitting them, and they're always armor four. They got the nano screen, the armor one, and no matter where they are, no matter what angle you try to get on them, you're never going to get them out of cover because of the nano screen. So, and you got to do three wounds to remove them, and it's got the little buddy protector. It's just a great, solid, all-around unit that's not too expensive, and yeah, like it a lot.
Yeah, just don't put your little buddy too close to your main guy with, like, missile launchers and heavy rocket launchers, because I would just shoot the checks so that you don't have to have that nano screen partial cover mod.
Yeah, but then you have the mimetism from the Chaxa.
Oh, that's true. It's very true. It's a very good point. So I guess it's the same. Mm-hmm. It's exactly the same. So never mind. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. I didn't even see that.
But they, you know, they can be 8 inches apart.
Yeah.
And
no, I totally didn't.
There's no reason for them to be closer than 2.5-3 inches. You know, in that template range. No reason for it. Plenty of room to spread out.
For real. Yeah, I didn't see that mimetism. That's funny. Because guess what? I am an idiot. So my next one, it's almost like a troll because I don't think that they have these models in the line. You tell me about that, Tom, the Tekkyo officer.
They do not have models.
Yeah.
They were on my list that got crossed out eventually other things, but so I'm with you here.
Yeah, no, I think they're really awesome because of the fact that they have fair aware tactics, endgame and mirror ball. So I've faced off against both of those, and it sucks. It really sucks. So the fact that every profile gets that, I think, is amazing. On top of the lieutenant plus one order, they have the option to do plus one command token as well. Or you can take them as chain of command. But I'm always down for that plus one order. Which will fit into one of my other favorites because of this. They kind of come as a pair. But yeah, it's not bad. I mean, you're a whip 14, so that's pretty good for your lieutenant role. And it's a sturdy lieutenant because it has two wounds. Because you have your one wound, and then you go to inactive symbiote armor.
And so, armor 3 BTS-6 on the active armor.
Yeah, that's amazing. So we keep talking about viral, right? Well, a lot of the Tohaa profiles have high BTS, you know, because they're used to those viruses, and it's all that symbiote armor keeps them safer. So I like that. Has regeneration and immune to shock, so that's really good too. So if you do lose, somebody hits you with viral, if you fail both BTS rolls, right? You have a chance to get back up
that's,
for free, which is really nice.
That's, you know, how N3, anything with more than one wound on the profile is shock. Yeah. And do things that have active and inactive symbiote armor, each with one, do they count as two? Yes, they do. That was in the old FAQs, right? So now it's just immunity shock on both profiles.
Yeah. And again, it's a triad, so you can run them around if you want it to be... you know, a lieutenant that's running around, which is kind of crazy. I would kind of prefer him, like, sitting back, just giving a bonus to a long-range gun.
Yeah, he's his own little bunker, because if you can tuck him back in a corner where they've got to come all the way around, and by the time they get to where they could see him or attack him, they're within your 8 inches, your zone of control, where you can isolate them with endgame. And then... you know, you just throw mirror balls eclipse, right?
Yeah, it's basically it's an eclipse. You just place a template anywhere within your zone of control.
Yeah, so throw that out to block the front of his little corner where he's hiding. Now they can't see to shoot. But you can put him in a place where they've got to get within 8 inches of him one way or another to deal with him, and boom, they're isolated. Perhaps. So he protects himself pretty well.
Yeah, it is. It is. And by the way, I was going to say that because when you said isolated, I don't think he... Does he have a racer? Endgame? No, it's just Endgame and Mirror
Ball. Oh, I thought...
So Endgame just does the wound.
I flipped them in my head. I'm sorry.
I just... But I had to double make sure because I haven't used them yet. I had them used against me, but I double checked that.
Flipped them in my head.
So yeah, you get it within eight and then he's hacking you because it's wounds.
Yeah, no line of fire
required.
Yeah,
no line of fire. It sucks.
Can just do a wound. It's damage 13, yeah?
I believe so. Let me go back. Yeah, it's damage 13, BTS. Armor piercing. So halves your BTS, which is, that's a big deal. Dude, I was so scared of these guys when I played against them. I was like, I don't want to get anywhere near you.
Yep.
That's nuts. Just start popping half BTS rolls on me. That's no fun.
Chain of Command is a good option if you are taking a Rasail Lieutenant to Rambo around. Plus one command token is useful to reform your triads, have five instead of four. And there is only one time, really, that unless you want to Rambo the Takeul himself, taking the Lieutenant plus one order, there's only one model in the range that has NCO to take advantage of that. And so it's the Ectros HMG. And so if you're taking that, then plus one order is probably the best option.
Yeah.
Or if you plan to use him as his own Rambo, because he's got a viral combi rifle profile. He's got a Spitfire profile. He can go out and kill some stuff with his ballistic skill of 13. That's elite in Tohaa.
Right.
So that's another good use of the plus one order. Otherwise, I'm thinking I'm taking the plus one command token for when triads break. You got two broken ones next to each other. You can reform them into a new one. But you need command tokens to do it. So
on my top five, the profile that I like the most is the plus one order viral combi. Unless I don't have points, then I'll take the regular combi. But it's one of those two.
Was that an 8-point difference between combi and viral?
Six points. That's kind of a big deal. Yep. Especially if you never intend to use it. It's not worth it. Like, the combi's probably the best.
if you're using him as an offensive lieutenant, then that's a different matter.
Yeah, or you're
viral.
If you're on a map where you know that somebody's going to get close enough while in line of fire. Like, if you're playing on a map that has no inside buildings, and you're just out in the open, so maybe... I mean, like, no interior buildings is what I meant. Buildings
it's
with
so
interiors.
Funny that a model with NCO... can use the lieutenant orders to activate a triad, but if he's in a triad...
Yeah, right?
He can't use his own two orders to activate the triad.
It's silly.
He's more of a... He'd be a solo operator at that point.
Yeah, it's kind of silly.
It's very silly.
Yeah, very, very silly.
No, good choice. He was on the short list. But unless you have more on the Takeul.
No, I have stuff to go off of that, but I'll wait till my turn.
Sukeul Commandos are on my list. So, two wounds because of the symbiont armor and the transmutation, right? They start at armor 2, BTS 3. They have mimetism minus 3. They can join triads, okay? And they are veteran. So, you know, you can oblivion them all you want. Or eraser them, not endgame them. Why'd they make them both E-words? sorry for flipping those around. So it can triad. It's ballistic skill 13 and mimetism minus 3. Mm-hmm. And it's in a triad, so it's plus 1 burst. And you have K1 combi rifle is like the base model, and that's a forward observer. Actually, the cheapest is the sniper, but he costs SWC.
That's so funny.
Whip 13 forward observers with K1 combi rifles. They bring along D charges. Much like A-List did, just because, you know, just in case you draw that card. Plus one burst breaker pistols. That's on all of the profiles for up-close work. But the ones I see most, there is a K1 sniper rifle option. But the ones I see most are the heavy machine gun.
Yep.
Leading an offensive triad, right, with a Makaul to throw smoke, keep him safe. And, some kind of specialist along for the ride. Or as a defensive team, the missile launcher.
Yeah.
With plus one burst and mimetism, BS-13, that burst 2 missile launcher in a triad is scary. And this is the one that like stays in your deployment zone, mm-hmm. covering the table from far away, and has like your symbiomate guy, the Kaletar. Mm-hmm. Right, he's part of that triad because he doesn't want to be out running around doing stuff. He's not really great at anything except bringing mates for people,
throwing his pokeballs out.
So he's part of this triad, and he just sits back there behind a building, out of sight, while the missile sits up there being scary. The burst 5 heavy machine gun in the active turn is bananas. And then this is Tohaa, not Spiral Core, but in a tri core.
Oh yeah,
ballistic skill 16.
Yeah,
nightmare fuel.
Spiral's kind of nuts with that.
And then veteran being essentially immune to
isolation,
mm-hmm. man, is, and total terrain's no joke. We got these stupid gravity well things in the ITS packet.
Yeah.
And, having terrain total, don't care. Run into a forest, don't care.
Mm-hmm.
Can go wherever, and they're just scary. Scary.
They are. They're on my list too. That made my top five. So this is our other one that we had the same. But for that, I think they're a cool, like backstory in the lore. Right. I think they're pretty awesome. Mm-hmm. So that's one reason they made it. But they're just like when I see them on the table, they frighten me. Like I immediately am like I have to take that out. So I had to put that in my top five. I also like that they have. Breaker pistols plus one burst because, you know, you're running your HMG and then if somebody gets up close, like a breaker pistol's no joke, especially with the plus one burst. That means you're burst 3 in ARO. it's just unless the plus one burst is only on your active turn. I can't remember if it said that.
It is. But,
okay, but so never mind.
You're burst 2 from the fire team, though.
Yeah, so having those threes is really, really nice when you're up close. So I think it's a really good offensive piece because as you're getting closer and closer and closer, you could just switch to that. Especially if you're playing against Ariadna. So, and yeah, just the mimetism -3 too. It's if you don't have visors, it sucks.
And then 8-16 is dicey, but that's what one of the other triad members is for.
Yeah, exactly.
You're one that's not the McCall because yep. you don't want to pay 3 extra points for a combi rifle you're never going to use.
Yep.
But, you know, the bioengineer has a combi.
Yep.
And that might be your third member, some other specialist. Sakiel maybe with a viral. Mm-hmm.
Or your Aelis. With her viral combi rifle, too.
Now all your D-charges are in one place.
Oh, that's true. That's a bad... See, man?
But no, I want to take two Sukiels, just like I said, one in a defensive team that doesn't move and just mm-hmm. scares everyone from afar, and then one as the point man
yeah.
on an offensive triad wreaking havoc.
Oh yeah, man. So my next one, I told you this one made my top list just because I like the idea of this. And it's an old school Tohaa model before they got all these extra upgrades. And it is specifically the Ektros NCO HMG because it is a triad. And having that NCO, having two extra orders, it's just crazy. So it's like, what makes Tohaa so efficient? You're running all these triads, so you're moving, you know, your three models with one order,
mm-hmm.
with all these multiple fire teams. You get as many as you want, as long as they're, you know, they're only three members. So they're extremely order efficient. So let's give them two extra orders. So this is how you can play that. Tohaa list that has 17 orders in it. You know what I mean? Because they can, you know, you have your 10, your 5, and then this Ektros has 2. So, I mean, this would be a good one to put in that 5 group because now that group has 7. It's really scary. Like it a lot. And it's, you know, it's your standard heavy infantry type of platform. A little bit less because they're only armor three BTS 6,
but an extra wound.
Yeah, but they're 2 wounds, and then once they lose those 2 wounds, they go to inactive armor. So there's a 3 wound. They're a 3 wound mm-hmm. platform. It's really, really nice, especially if you're rocking a bioengineer with them that can bring them back if they go down to unconscious. You know, it has a Pulsar too in case somebody gets close. You're shooting them with that.
Giant nanopulsar.
Yeah, pretty much. But yeah, 6-2 moves really nice when you can move 6 inches and then shoot on that platform of BS-13. Not too shabby. Dodge plus 1 inch with a Visiga 14. So in a pinch, that's really nice. But yeah, really, I like them a lot, especially because they're just one of the old school ones. And I think that the Tachiel plus 1 order with the Ektros NCO is just, I think it sounds fun. And I haven't seen that used against me yet. I haven't played against Tohaa so much since N4, though.
So before I do my fifth one, I just want to talk about why is Jan Star only 2 points more than a generic Q-Tan imposter? They're AVA-1 spread out amongst them. You can't take Jan and a Q-Tan, right? It's one or the other.
Oh.
And for 2 points, you get plus 3 close combat.
Okay.
And you add CC minus 3, so the enemy's an additional minus 3 against you.
Okay.
Okay. Her physique stays 11 when she goes inactive, and it goes down to a 10 when the Q-Tan goes inactive. Jan Star gets mines that the Q-Tan doesn't have.
Mm-hmm.
She has a shotgun. They have a combi.
That's probably
so
where.
I mean, except that you are either plus 6 or have a template option.
Yeah.
Instead of just plus 3 out to 16. Her viral pistol gets plus 1 burst.
Yeah, that's nice.
Over the generic. I mean, she is half an SWC more than the generic, but she's only 2 points more for all of those upgrades.
Yeah, dude, shotguns get a huge discount in points. And I think it's just because their range bad, and once you're out of 8, they just get really bad. And they're only burst 2 if you do hit. So I think that that's why.
Well, when you think about the impersonation rules and where you're starting the game, I don't think that combi rifle is an advantage.
I would agree with you on that.
It's just, it's very silly to me. Anyway, all right, are you ready for my number 5?
Yes.
Okay. Or not my number 5, but
your fifth.
My fifth one
on
again.
The top, yeah.
They're in order of how we go down the thing. It's the Gorgos.
Oh, really?
Dude, okay. It's 4 wounds.
It is, because, oh, yeah.
It's got 3 it wounds on the on active.
Mm-hmm.
And then still has 1 wound after that in the inactive symbiote.
What, it's running around in its underwear?
Right. Goes from silhouette 7 to silhouette 2 when it transmutes after taking 3 wounds. So it's got 4 wounds to get to remove these points from the table. And at the point where you're just about ready to take the last wound, all of a sudden you can't see it.
Yeah.
Because it got small. It's BS attack plus 1 damage, and so it's AP Spitfire. It's cutting cutting your armor in half, hitting at damage 15. So you got a burst 4, damage 15 gun that is plus 3 from 8 to 24 inches, right?
Mm-hmm.
Has a pulsar, the giant teardrop nanopulsar, right? Mm-hmm. Viral close combat weapon, fine. Close combat 19. Whatever you if you're in close combat, you're probably dying. But,
yeah.
But should you hit, viral's gonna hurt. For 4 wounds, you're looking at 71 points. The cheapest is 67, but it doesn't get its little buddy.
Yeah, I like the buddy.
Which is what really makes. And so at 71 points, you get the Pulsar version of the Chaxa peripheral. So this is just like the Resail. You have 2 guys that can present from 2 different angles and make them make choices. Well, I've got a template that's going to hit me in the BTS, or it might chuck an EM grenade at me.
Yeah, right?
And that's no fun. For 3 points more, 74 points, you can get the light shotgun Chaxa, who still also has EM grenades. So now he's got a small template, or he's got a plus 6 band, or he's got EM grenades with a circular blast and plus 3 to hit, right? Mm-hmm. And so all these options for the little buddy. So with the burst 4 Spitfire and then a burst 2 light shotgun, you're pumping out 6 shots in a single order.
Mm-hmm.
You've got 4 wounds plus the wound on the Chaxa, and it's 71 or 74 points.
Yeah, I like that idea of that 74.1, because then you're really making bad decisions.
Mm-hmm.
because that light shotgun, if they dodge, then you just shoot with both. Mm-hmm. Or if it is somebody that to EM, then you can EM, you know, throw your EM grenade. But I like to be able to shoot. And then if they're like, well, I'll shoot back. And like, well, I'm going to template you. Mm-hmm. And then the Gorgos just shoots back so that it's face to face.
Ballistic skill 14.
Yeah.
And armor 7 with the first three wounds. Armor 1 with the final wound. But, you know, armor 7, BTS 9 for the first three wounds. Physique of 16, but then dodges on an 11. But if it succeeds, it goes 3 inches. Tactical awareness, of course, it's a tag, so yeah. it gets an extra free order that it can use. So, and you get that for 74 points.
God, they are better now with the new cover rules and crit rules.
Yeah, armor 10 all the time.
Yeah, it's really neat.
And yeah, getting to roll armor, albeit one extra time, mm-hmm. against crits instead of just taking hits. No longer being killed by fire outright.
Yeah, that was... You would never see a Gorgos in the old school days. One wrong fire move and you're just off the table.
And, you know, in that first turn, if they're a little outside your 24-inch AP damage 15 Spitfire range, you've got Flammenspeer.
Yeah.
And so... You know, you get two uses out of that, or his Chax is not baggage, right?
No, I was looking right now because I was like, that would be broken. It's just broken AF if it had baggage.
But yeah, so 16 to 32, you're plus 3 with the continuous damage. Damage 14, mm-hmm. With a circular template if you want it to ignore armor or hit people nearby. Or hit mode if you have a friend nearby and don't want to cancel your own shot. So a couple of Flammenspiels. He's got the AP Spitfire damage 15. Throwing out 6 shots with his little buddy when you're in range. And little buddy at 6'4", he can easily get to his plus 6 range while mm-hmm. the Gorgos stays back at his plus 3 range with the Spitfire.
Yep.
Coming at you from different angles. It is a great package for a great price, and I still really like the model.
Yeah, Gorgos is pretty cool.
But need that inactive symbiomate version of it to be included in the box so you can switch it out.
Right.
Instead of just using Artichoke Beyonce.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they're way better now in N4. That's a really... I'm glad you picked that in your top 5. Because I haven't seen Gorgos in a while, and I think that it is now its time. So my last one on my list is on here for similar reasons as the Tachyel officers, and they are the Kriegel agents.
Really?
Yes. And the reason is they can triad, mm-hmm. and they're only AVA-1, though. So you can only take one of them, but... Triading it. You should try adding it. Putting it in a triad where you're going to be running up the table, I think, is really good because it has Fairware Tactics, Eraser, and Mirror Ball. So this is the one that puts you in isolation. Yep. So it erases you from the order pool and then has Mirror Ball. So...
So you don't technically need a McCall.
You don't technically need a McCall. And again, you don't need line of fire either. So you can literally just put it on the other side of a building that you're eventually going to run through. So mirror ball is just disgusting now. And then in defense mode, it's if somebody's coming around to attack your triad and they're within 8 inches of your Kriegel, boom, you erase them. Then you just stop their reign of terror because mm-hmm. now they can't use any more orders because they're isolated. It's great, and you don't need line of fire to do it. So really, really scary. And they're definitely a support because it's either 25 points, you're taking a submachine gun, and a Pharaoh booster, mm-hmm. which is like Ford Observing on steroids, because it's like you can either do hit mode, and it's like damage 16, but it's only burst 1. And it's good from 16 to 24 inches as its plus 3 range. And then it goes up to minus 3 from 32 to 48. Damage 16 to your BTS. If you fail it, you're targeted. And then you could do the burst 2, damage 14. So it's basically like shooting you with a stink bomb. So that version of targeted is they just smell you really good for the Pharaoh booster. So that's kind of cool. Or for the 22 points, but this one costs half an SWC. You get the breaker combi and grenade launcher. I just find it funny. It
puts you in this targeted state.
Yeah, it puts you targeted. So it's like being forward observed, but
out of line of fire.
You need line of fire for it.
This is not a.
But instead of being damage 13. It's you either do a 14 or one shot at a 16, so it's a lot easier to hit. I mean, a lot easier to get them targeted. It's funny with the Pharaoh booster, the breaker combi and grenade launcher is really interesting because you could Pharaoh boost them and move and then just start lobbing grenades from out of line of fire, right? Which is pretty funny. Or after you put mirror ball up, so you know what I mean, like make sure they don't see you. I think they're cool. Really good way to just mess with people without putting yourself in harm's way, right? Because it's not like it's a hacker or heavy infantry, so like hackers can't really hack you back. Like their Pharaohware tactics are really lame because it's like anything with a wound. I'm just going to mess with you, or I'm going to throw up a mirror ball and do an eclipse zone here. So I like them a lot. And again, I saw how nasty they could be firsthand. All of those Pharaohware tactics, and then if I want to say another thing is the symbio bombs, you know, like all of those, it makes it really scary to get close to them. Jay had a bunch, man, and I didn't want to mess with him. I ran in once and went, oh, that's what this does?
Availability one.
Yeah. But you have that in the your tactical officers, right? Doing those Pharaohware tactics. And then the symbio bombs as well. So
unless he was playing Spiral, because then they're availability two.
No, I think he was playing... He could have been playing Spiral. I can't remember. I thought it was Tohaa. I thought it was regular Tohaa.
Hard to tell. Was there a tri-core?
No, he was a regular Tohaa.
Okay.
But he played the Steel Phalanx version of Tohaa. We both had limited insertion lists, which isn't a thing anymore. One order. combat group of 10. Just one combat group. It was pretty nice. And he had a lot of mimetism on the table. But yeah, they're just... I like them. I like the Pharaohware tactics. I think that it's a great change from the old style of what they used to do.
And, you know, like I said, there's a bunch of stuff that was on the list that had to get crossed off. Like I mentioned, the tactical officer didn't quite make my 5 favorite cut. Clipsos on there because they're your infiltrating camouflage hidden deployment specialists that get the work done.
Mm-hmm.
I had the Ektros and specifically the NCO HMG. Paired with the tactical officer, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, Nima, of course, who gets all the benefits of being an Ektros, but she's also cheaper. And she's a lieutenant level 2 or a lieutenant plus 1 order that adds SWC to your army.
Yeah, that's always nice.
You know, the Sakil regiment is always solid for their price point and being in a triad and shooting viral combis at things.
Mm-hmm.
For only like 23 points, and they have EM grenades, only physique 11, but still. Always like the Nicul ambush unit.
Nicul's are cool.
So, you know, sapper, giving them mimetism minus 3 and cover from all directions, no matter where they are, as long as they can fit the Silhouette 3 base. With an MSV1 viral sniper and 2 wounds because of transmutation, you know. And shock mind layer. So, yeah, the real good. My old standby, Kumo Tail Bioengineers, they're a doctor and an engineer at whip 14, and they can triad. Only one wound, but those...
I was surprised you didn't have Nighthawk on there.
Yeah. Just to note that Gowrail is the only MSV2 in the faction, so it's important to have. There's your triad. Your Saka... what do they call it? Sukeul?
Sukeul Missile Launcher.
Your Gowrail Sniper, and then your... The guy who brought the mates, chilling in the back.
Yeah.
Trying to be unmolested. So, you know, there's a lot of good stuff.
You know which one was honorable mention on mine? Just because I like the idea of them, are the Reeks Escorts.
Really?
Yeah, because I just think it's the idea of them are funny, because they're Silhouette 1. And
The profile.
Yeah, on the profile.
Models are a little large.
Yeah, they're Silhouette 1, but they can special fire team with the Kriegels. And just the idea of you have the Kriegels out there messing with people, and there's these little, like, halflings shooting Spitfires. Because it's a cheap Spitfire. It's 16 points for one SWC. They're only BS-11.
That's why.
And then you can get the K1 Marksman for 18, or a Boarding Shotgun and Contender for 13 points. So they're cheap, right? They're cheaper than Camille's. And because the Camille Spitfire is 18 and 1. So I just think the idea of them are funny, because you just see these little, basically gremlins, right? I envision, like, gremlins popping out. Shooting you with a Spitfire. Oh, man. So, yeah, I just like the idea of them. I have never seen them or faced them in a game. So, it's not the most...
Because there's so much good stuff to take.
Yeah, exactly.
But, let us know what... if your favorite Tohaa unit didn't make either of our lists, I think we ended up with a top 8.
Yeah, we had a top 8 this time.
So with two selections being identical and almost more.
Yeah.
But so let us know if your top unit didn't make it in, and tell us what your favorites are at tom@mayacast.com.
And kip@mayacast.com.
Conversation can serve no purpose anymore. Goodbye.
So that's going to wrap up our hashtag 5 the Tohaa episode 332. And I wonder what faction we should do next.
I just realized we messed up.
How?
We should have did...
333?
We should have did this on episode 333. Ah!
Well, the... Having a top 8 and calling it 5 the Tohaa is already messed up enough.
No, but then that makes sense, because it's episode 332, so it's the 3 plus 2 is 5, and then you add the other 3 in, and it's our 8, so it works. It's our top 5, you know, it's our top 5, but it was really a top 8 today. So.
Would you like to win free miniatures? Because we give out free miniatures every quarter. And some people recently just won free miniatures.
Yeah.
And some of them still need to get in touch with us to let us know what they want so we can order them so we can ship everyone's out.
Yeah.
So make sure if you entered the last MayaCast Masterclass to go back, listen, see if you heard your name, and let us know what we can send you, please, so that everybody can get their stuff. But that's what we're talking about. MayaCast Masterclass is a painting event that we do every quarter where we give out a bunch of prizes to random participants. Kip? Tell them about it.
Yeah, you just have to follow what our theme is for the quarter. So we give you a theme, and then you have, you know, roughly till the end of the quarter to paint your minis and submit them. And the cool thing is, the only prize that's judged off of your painting skills is the overall winner. That's the coveted Master Glass pint or rocks glass with our awesome little... hacker logo made by Tim Toulin, so blame him for that. And you get it customized with your name. It could be whatever you want on there. But every other prize goes to random selections from random.org of all of the participants, because we want to reward people just for participating. And it gets people going, because, you know, like, painting competitions can be intimidating. You're like, well, I'm never going to win. But this, it allows you to work on your stuff and not, you know, stress-free. So this quarter's theme is one of my favorites, and it is called memes. And what we meme by that is what we want you to do is paint up a miniature. So it could be, it's only one, and it could be any miniature that you want. So whatever you're working on, it qualifies. And when you're done, one of the pictures we want you to submit is that model painted, featured in the meme. And that could be however you want. You know, it could just be the model and you dumb joke, or you can, you know, let your creativity flow. But we do need four other pictures of it just painted normal. So as you're setting up, take a before picture, because the main thing is we like them new. And then save that into a file. Meme contest. And then paint your mini, and when you're done, take up to four pictures, or select up to your four best pictures that you took of it, and rename those files with your name. So like Tom Shadle and then one. Don't add the number before your name. Tom Shadle 2. And then make your meme out of it. And once you've done that, you send your before picture, all four of your finished, and your meme attached as attachments in an email to
tom@mayacast.com
and kip@mayacast.com.
Well done, Kip. And yeah, we choose the overall best painter to win the Master Glass. All the other prizes that we give out are randomly selected from all successful participants. You can't win if you don't play.
Yeah.
And the more entries we get, the more we give away. Mm-hmm. So say goodbye, Kip.
Goodbye, Kip.
That's going to do it for this episode of MayaCast. Until next time, get out there and support your local game stores.
To find out how you can support the show, go to patreon.com/MayaCast.
You can find us online at www.MayaCast.com.
We are on Facebook at facebook.com/InfinityMayaCast.
Follow at MayaPodcast on Twitter.
Join the MayaCast forum group on Facebook.
And as always, you can email us at tom@mayacast.com
and kip@mayacast.com.